Namaste. The seed that Dr. G planted in Nagpur bears fruit all across the world. Some thoughts and work have crossed national borders and have spread beyond Bharat. It continues to work for the society even in foreign lands, connecting and uniting Hindus across the globe in many different ways. Let's see a few examples today of how the seed of Hinduism is propagated in different ways across the world. Here, you can see some employees chanting in their tea break.
Should come to office. I don't get any time to do exercise because of this.
That's true. After that, once you start working, we hardly get time to even stretch or relax. I've already started putting on weight.
Same here. No time to go to gym. But you know what? Recently, I learned a few simple yoga postures called Surya Namaskar from my friend, and that helped me a lot.
Oh, really? Tell us how.
Actually, my friend said there is a yogathon going on this month. People are doing these postures called Surya Namaskar together in gyms, in community parks, even in office. If you want, we all can do it together in our office. You only need a yoga mat and some time.
Sure thing, we'll do it. It's good for everybody.
Okay then, I'll show you how to do it.
How our Karyakartas use the lessons learned in Shaka in their everyday lives to help others and to contribute to society. Let's see another example of how some enables pride in Hindus for Hindu society.
The branch of the Sangh, which started and has now spread outside Bharat, has always tried to help in local social issues. Until 2015, Californian history textbooks for elementary schools had represented the Hindu religion inappropriately, embarrassing Hindu kids and their parents. Let us now see how our sevaks, sevikas and balas, based on their Shaka experiences, helped change the textbooks for the entire state of California. Here is a scene from one Hindu family discussing at home.
Hindus believe in caste system and untouchability, and still produce stupid things like cows, snakes, and whatnot.
That is absolutely incorrect. Let me explain to you what is correct about Hinduism. Also, don't forget all that you have learned about Hinduism in Shaka.
Yoshi's parents are trying to explain.
Wow, Hinduism is so enlightening and has provided so many benefits to the world. I didn't know about this at all. We really need to set the record straight and correct the temple. But how do we do it?
I heard the state education department holds annual hearing on textbooks. I'll follow when it's the next team and we then hearing and make our way forward. And I think you are now fully informed to lead the charge and present at the game.
I know, I'll be a little bit nervous, but I'd really like to change the pilgrimage for my illusion.
The family has come for the sacramento.
Hi everyone, the annual hearing for proposals to revise California textbooks is in session. First up is Kushi, a 6th year from Forest Park Elementary School in Fairmont, California. Please proceed.
Thank you all for giving me the opportunity to be heard. I'm here to place correction in the 6th grade social studies textbook, and specifically to the chapter on Hinduism. As currently written, the chapter includes many mistakes. For example, it mentions the caste system and untouchability. However, this is not part of Hinduism. Rather, it was a societal change that is slowly being discarded. Also, the chapter talks of Hindus praying to cows and snakes, without providing any background context. The fact is, Hindus believe in preservation and sacredness of all souls, including cows and other animals. And giving respect to cows is a symbolism of this concept.
Thank you so much, Ms. Kushi, for sharing these insights on Hinduism. You'll definitely be curious and revise the textbooks to reflect the deeper meaning of this wonderful religion. Thank you.
The efforts of HSS and other organizations to correct this were finally successful when the California State School Board corrected the textbooks in response to suggestions. HSS helped to make local Hindu children aware of their religion.
Traditional Ganesh Vandana.
experienced this before. Let me show you some more. This is Bala Gokula. Here, kids have fun learning about their culture and their religion.
people.